people every year take their own lives, and a new documentary takes a look at how suicide affects those who are left behind. It's called The Ripple Effect, and it's been made by Kevin Hines, a man who survived jumping from the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. Here's a preview.
I was compelled to die. In 4 seconds, I fell 75 miles an hour, 25 stories, and I hit the water.
Nobody thinks about the ones that have to go pick it up. 57 dead bodies had to pick up. People, you were the only one alive.
I was very nearly a statistic, and the facts are that Aboriginal men are 6 times more likely to die by suicide.
I found out Dwayne, you know, took his life. My first initial reactions were, it was my fault. It shattered people's lives. It wasn't just a thing where it changed them for a week or a month or 6 months. It was a lifetime.
I have now lived 15 years past the day I should have died. And I'm truly grateful for that second chance at life.
Kevin Hines is an extraordinary bloke and is with us now. Welcome to Studio 10.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you.
It's nice to see you in the flesh because I've interviewed you before. This is a powerful documentary with a really powerful message. It talks about the people who are affected by suicide. Did you think about that at all when you were standing on the edge of the Golden Gate Bridge back in the year 2000 about to jump? Had you thought about the impact it might have on other people?
You know, sadly, I couldn't. I was hearing voices in my head due to psychosis and mental illness telling me I had to die, telling me I was useless, that I had no value, and that my family wanted me gone. The last thing I could think about was hurting them. I didn't know I would. I was so unwell. It was the worst action I ever took. I'm grateful that I get to exist every single day. It's incredible that I get to be here. And if I get to be here, I'm going to try to help other people stay too.
An important part of your story, which I always remember, is as you were standing, preparing to jump, you were saying to yourself, if one person says to me, are you okay, you wouldn't do it.
If one person on the bus ride there or anywhere near the bridge said, are you okay, is something wrong, or can I help you, I was willing and ready to tell that individual anything and everything. Sadly, nobody reacted like that.
But that's how powerful those three words can be.
Absolutely. What we don't recognize as loved ones of people who are suicidal is that sometimes it's the smallest amount of kindness and compassion that can lead someone to change their life.
You've also said as well before that the moment you stood, you took the step off the bridge, you instantly regretted your decision.
This is a common theme we hear all around the world in the travels we do for suicide prevention. People of all means of suicide coming forward and saying after their survival, at the second that my hands left the rail, like me, or at the second that I did this or that, my only thought was, what have I just done? I don't want to die.
Mm. You're right.
It's a long-term solution to a short-term problem, isn't it, suicide and taking your own life?
It is for a lot of people. But there are people like myself who live with chronic thoughts of suicide. I live with these thoughts on a regular basis today. I live with every symptom of bipolar disorder that I've ever had. But I've mitigated. I work tirelessly for my brain health through exercise, eating healthy, and educating myself as to my diagnosis to stay here every day. Yeah. And my goal every day is to just find a way to be here tomorrow and the next day to be here after that.
Yeah.
Have you been back to the bridge? And does the going back to the bridge give you a sense of foreboding or?
The first time was terrifying. My father called me. He said, Kev, we're going for a drive. We get in the car. We show up at the parking lot of the Golden Gate Bridge.
Thanks, Dad.
I said, Dad, I don't want to be here. I don't want to do this. He said, Kevin, it's the anniversary of your attempt. We need closure. We walked out onto the bridge. He held my hand. We said a prayer, and we dropped a flower over the rail, and the flower went down. It hit the water. It made the smallest of ripple effects, which is why we called it the film Suicide, the Ripple Effect, and 2 feet to the right popped up a sea lion. And that is crucial because in the water, when I was in the water struggling to stay afloat to survive, a sea lion lifted me up from beneath the water surface, kept me buoyant and afloat until the Coast Guard boat arrived behind me. So we go back a year later and we drop that flower, and there he was. I call him Herbert because he saved my life.
And when you were in the water, that just after landing, what were your thoughts then? Like, I failed at this, or I'm so happy.
The fall, all I could think was, what have I just done? I don't want to die. God, please save me. I came to the surface and I prayed repeatedly that I would live. I broke my back in 3 places. I went from wheelchair to walking to back brace into cane. But here's the thing. We're all here for a reason. We all have a purpose. We are all intended to be here. And that's what this film is about. It's about finding a willpower to stay. And we have had 120 people say that by watching this film, It has saved their life.
Wow. Amazing.
It's been seen by 15,000 people all over the world. It's here in Australia. Tomorrow, in fact, at Randwick. Is that what it's called?
Randwick
Cinemas at 6:15 is the film in Sydney. It'll be in Melbourne the next day and Brisbane after that. And we just hope people can see this film and start the path to changing their lives.
We've seen a number of really high-profile suicides in recent times.
Yeah.
Do you feel we're reporting them correctly? We have various guidelines. We're encouraged. What do you think is the best way to avoid copycats?
I feel like Studio 10 is reporting them accurately and properly and appropriately. I've noticed that for some time, actually. I watch you guys. So you guys are doing a great job being safe with your messaging. There are a great many media factors that are so sensationalistic about a story like mine that it actually is damaging to the people watching. You guys do a great job of honing that in and focusing on what really matters. And what really matters in this situation is how I live, stay, and find recovery every day. I have every symptom I've ever had today. I just know how to fight it with the power of routine, regimen, and an art of wellness toolkit that I wrote with one of the greatest suicidologists in this field.
And what I love about this movie as well is that it looks at suicide from all different angles. The fact that it's the ripple effect, and I was so surprised to hear this stat that one suicide affects on average around 115 people. So why is it important then to push that message when you said, for example, you were so unwell that you couldn't think of anything else other than just wanting to end your pain? Do you think this might give people pause for thought if they realise just how many people care about them?
If they realise how many people care and how valuable they truly are. And through this film, what we're doing is showing people not just the negative ripple effect of suicide, the devastating ripple effect of suicide, but the massively powerful and positive and emotive and impactful powerhouse that the ripple effect can have of a person who's telling their lived experience in a proper way with safe messaging that can help somebody else stay here.
We have a real problem here in this country, as I'm sure you do in yours as well. 8 men take their lives every single day in Australia. A few women as well take their lives. If someone is watching this, considering doing the unthinkable, what would you say to them? What advice would you give to them?
I'm gonna look right here. If you are out there and you are suicidal and you are contemplating taking your life, please stop, breathe. Take a moment to recognize that you are resilient enough to be right here, right now. You've gone through hell. You're still around. You can maintain. You can fight the pain in spite of the pain to thrive today and every day. It's about hard work because nothing good ever came without it. I live with this disease every day. I fight it every day. I fight suicidal thoughts on a regular basis. They will never kill me. They will never kill me because each and every time I will beg, ask, and plead for help to the person to my right or the person to my left or anybody willing to listen who's empathetic and kind.
You are an extraordinary man. Well said, Kevin. And Kevin's holding talks in Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane. He's also screening his documentary, The Ripple Effect. You can head to suicidetherippleeffect.com for details. Kevin, thank you for talking to us this morning. And as well, we have to put it out there that Lifeline can always be contacted anytime. It's a 24-hour number, 131114. Call that number if you are having dark thoughts. Kevin, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Let's take a break. See you soon. Welcome to Studio 10.